well, 10, yeah, the 10-month journey, I was in Southeast Asia for 4.5 months. I was in Europe for 2.5 months, and now I'm in Africa. I'm actually supposed to be in South America, but I decided to not go and stay in Africa because I love Africa so much.
How many African countries have you been in?
Let's see. South Africa, Egypt, Kenya, Tanzania, Ghana, Senegal, Morocco, and that's it so far.
That's it?
Yeah.
And which one do you like more?
Oh, don't make me choose. Come on.
I don't make you choose.
Come on.
I don't care if it's not Ghana, though. I don't care. I just want to know. I just want you to speak your mind. Come on. Remember, see what's on my shirt? Just be real. Just be real with me.
All right. I love Morocco.
Tanzania would be my choice. Damn.
Why Tanzania?
Well, they got nice girls.
You know what?
Good food. I love the food. I love the food. As you know, I love the food. I've been there once, and all I did was stay inside and eat. Go outside, eat. That's it. I like the food. I didn't really want to go anywhere.
Really?
Dude, it's a nice view. You can see. Okay, no, you're not asking me a question. I'm asking you a question.
Oh. Yeah, I turned that around.
Damn, I gotta be careful. I told you I need to bounce up from here. Alright. The monster's not good here. The producer just arrived. Lady, alright, so yeah, tell me more about it. What prompted you to travel the world?
Basically, I was traveling for a couple of years, and when I had a 9-to-5, I was basically on a vacation every month. So I decided that, you know what, I'm just gonna stay gone. I'm gonna save up enough money to take a trip like this and just go. Give up everything and just be on the road full time.
So you gave up your job?
Yep, gave up my career. I was a homelessness aversion liaison for about 11 years. So I gave up my career to take a chance on living life.
How is it so far? I was living life in just 10 months.
I mean, it's been amazing. I got to do and see just about everything I wanted to. You know, within a very short time span. Like, I recommend folks to do it when they get out of college or whenever they feel like it. If it's after a marriage, if it's right now, like, go for it. Plan for it and just jump. Live your life.
Cliff. Just jump. Wait till you hit the ground. If you don't hit the ground, don't stop.
Get back up and try again.
All right. So, yeah, okay. So, what brought you to Ghana? Why Ghana?
Well, Ghana is special to me because I did my DNA ancestry test, and it traced me back here. I did my maternal test. I didn't do my father's side. I still have another side to do. However, it traced me back here to our Khan tribe, and I decided that, you know what? I'm going to go to Ghana and learn about my history, be with the people, be with the culture, just be with the land, engulf myself into all that Ghana has to offer. And now I'm here.
All right. So what have you found out so far? Have you found out what tribe you're from?
It's been narrowed down to two.
Okay. Which is?
I don't want to share.
Come on, sharing is caring. Are you going to tell me later?
I'll tell you later.
You sure?
Yeah.
Being your promise?
Yeah.
All right. Good. So I just want to find out. On your journey, has there been any enlightenment? Anything?
Enlightenment. I mean, enlightenment doesn't look as peaceful as is shown on pictures and stuff. But yes, there I had times where I was enlightened. And it was not fun, but it was something that needed to happen in order for me to get over the hump that I needed to get through. And at that time, it was everything I needed.
A lot of questions are going to be coming through. I'm going to ask you all the questions I'm going to ask everybody.
Get on my way.
Well, if you gave up your career, let me see, you're single?
I'm a singer?
Single.
Yes, I'm single.
Okay, what are your hobbies? You, stay away from her. She ain't even coming close to you. What else about you do you think people should know? I mean, you give up everything to travel the world. Are you going to stay in Ghana? Is that a plan?
I'm looking to stay in Ghana. I'm actually, this is my second time around because I want to stay here and work here, build here, and see how far I can go with Ghana.
Yeah, let's go to your name. Let's go to your name for me. Your name, your full name.
Larry La Thomas.
Larry La Thomas.
Mm-hmm.
That is. How'd you get your name?
I got my name because most folks said I act like a boy. So it's originally Larry. And I switched it to Larry. So sometimes I'm called both.
Wow. Well, you don't act like a boy. Well, you were.
I was a tomboy growing up, so yeah.
Yeah, a minute ago you were just.
I the tendencies are still there.
Jesus Christ, I might die here. Don't please come with my ass.
I won't. Just don't act up.
I always act up. Oh, you're cute as hell. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back talking to Natalie. Huh? Elaine, that's right.